video session. I hope you all have watched the previous videos and have understood the chapters well. Today, we are going to study lesson number 3, which is titled as Suvira, written by Paru Anand.
Hi, my dear friends. Through this chapter, I'll be sharing my experience of joining a new school in midterm. I'll tell you how my determination to succeed won over the recognition and acceptance of my new schoolmates. So, here we go.
Paru Anand is the author of several books for children and young adults, including plays, short stories, and novels. As a part of her work, she set up libraries and readers' clubs in rural India and conducted training programs on the use of literature. Some of her well-known works are Elephants Don't Diet, Pets Please, and Born to Lead. She is also a performance storyteller and has performed her stories in India and also in the UK, France, and Switzerland. She has been awarded for her contribution to children's literature by the Russian Center for Science and Culture. Dr. Abdul Kalam, the President of India, honored her for her writings on the Republic Day 2007. She has represented the country at various forums internationally, including in the UK and France. She is a performance storyteller and has performed her stories in many parts of India, UK, France, and Switzerland. She has written No Guns at My Son's Funeral, a book that has had extensive critical acclaim. The book was nominated onto the IBBY Honor List 2006 as the best book for young people from India. It is currently being translated into Spanish and German, and talks are on for basing a film on the book. A follow-up novel entitled Veed is the story of a son of a terrorist and his struggle to find an alternate life to sustain himself and his family.
Children, you must have experienced when you are studying, at times what happens is children join there are children taking admission in your school in the midterm, or they join your class in the mid of the session. Now, what do you observe at these times? Usually, the children who seeks admission and comes to your class, sometimes he has that a nervousness or they are shy, they don't interact much with the students, right? Isn't it? You must have observed that. And maybe if you, some of you, I'm sure must have, because of your parents' job or something, or for some other reason, you must have gone to some other city and you must have joined some other school, getting yourself, to keep yourself ready to enter into or to join the new students. It takes a little time. So now this story that we're going to study is about a girl, the narrator is actually joining a new school, that in the mid of a session. Now what she experiences there and how her confidence and her determination makes her popular and makes her loving amongst all the students, how that happens, that we'll be studying in this chapter. We will follow the same procedure as we've been doing in the previous videos. Here I have made just a slight change. I will show you a very short animation of that particular part that we'll be reading. So first I'll go with, you will watch that, a small clipping of that particular content. Then after that we will read the chapter, read that paragraph. And then I will be explaining the word meanings. And then I'll give a brief explanation of that paragraph. So I hope you all are ready. Let us proceed with that.
Before we begin with the chapter, let me introduce all the important characters of this chapter. The first and important character of our story is Suvira Mathur.
Hello friends, I'm Suvira.
Our next character is Anu.
Hi friends, I'm Anu. Nice to meet you all.
Next is Deepthi, my friend in the new school. Hello everyone, I'm Deepthi. I hope you all know the characters by now. Let's begin then. 3, 2, 1, here we go.
Sad day for the narrator as it was her last day in her school.
I have to leave the school and go to a new city. I will be missing you, Anu.
Oh, that's sad. I don't want you to go. You are my best friend. I too will miss you, my dear.
And then I had to leave my school forever. Ready to join a new one, new place, new people. Finally, we are leaving this room and heading for a new city. Little scared if I will get good friends and a good school there. Oh, mummy, I don't want to leave this place.
Don't worry, my sweetheart. You will love the new city as well as your school. Time to leave now.
Bye, friends.
And then we left. For a new city, new school and new friends.
In this story, the narrator recalls how difficult it was for her to change schools midterm. She goes on to tell how her courage and determination to succeed won her the acceptance and recognition from her new schoolmates. I'd arrived in the school in the middle of its term. It couldn't be helped. My father's life had suddenly taken a sharp U-turn. He had resigned from his job and decided to change tracks in his career. Our family had to pack up and leave our hometown. It was awful saying goodbye to all my old friends, especially Anu. And now our lives were turned upside down and each one of us was trying to cope with the changed circumstances as best as we could. But there was nothing to be done except wait and hope that this cloud too would have its silver lining.
Now, as we read the paragraph, children, the narrator begins saying that she had to leave her school in the mid of the session because her father actually had switched over to a new job in a new city. So they had no other option. They had to leave the city, the place, and she had to join a new school. Now, she was a little disheartened because it is a very normal tendency of a child who first of all adapts himself or herself in a particular environment with a few students and then finally going on again to a new place, again making yourself adaptable to a new environment. Now, the same situation happened with the narrator also. She was not a very grown-up child who could understand, but still, she understood the situation but she was a little sad because she had a good friend Anu in her school and she was very attached to her. She didn't want to leave her, but then finally she said, I had no other option. So I had to bid goodbye to my hometown and to my school. And then she proceeds with her parents to a new place.
Hi dear, are you a new student in our class? Yeah, I have joined the school today. Nice to meet you. Whoa, that's great. I am Deepthi. Let's be friends.
And so I was blessed to have one friend, Deepthi, on the very first day of my school. The next day was sports day in the school and I had given my name for 800 meters race. So I was a bit nervous but excited too.
My second day in the new school was marked with excitement. Trials were taking place for the inter-school athletics meet. The school teams were to be chosen and finalized. Every house had its favorite for each event. Packets of glucose for the last-minute energy boosts had been kept ready for those who were participating. You know, dear Deepthi, I'm not used to this chilly weather. And I'm a bit scared as all is new to me here. I don't know whether I'll be able to run well. Come on, my dear. I'm sure you will. I know you are sad as all are busy and no one knows you. But I'm sure everyone will know about you after you participate in this event. Thank you so much, dear. I'll try my best. You know, dear, not trying to bring your confidence down, but just making you aware. In this 800 meters event, you have a very, very strong contestant. And that is Miss Suvira Mathur. Who is she? Well, no one has ever beaten her in this event till date. And she is a Delhi inter-school record breaker. But you don't be scared. You can beat her, I'm sure. Oh, then I may not win. But where is she? I want to see her once. Yeah, sure. She is busy in the warm-up exercise. Come, I'll show you.
My second day in the new school was marked with excitement. Trials were taking place for the inter-school athletics meet. The school teams were to be chosen and finalized. Every house had its favorite for each event. Packets of glucose for last-minute energy boosts had been kept ready for those who were participating. I sat near the track, shaking my legs to keep off the mid-January chill. Mid-January chill here is the narrator is talking about the cold weather, about the winter that was there in the month of January. Let's continue. And also, I guess, the nervousness. I had come from Calcutta with its warmer climate and was unprepared for the sting of Delhi's chilly winter mornings. You all know that in the month of January, it's pretty cold. And the narrator had come from Calcutta, which doesn't have that cold climate. So she says she wasn't ready for that. Let's proceed. I wore a red t-shirt and white shorts. Red because I was put into the red house. But my housemates pretty much ignored me. Not that they were being unfriendly on purpose. Just that it was a busy day. A day to back the favorite, not some unknown. I also cursed myself for being stupid enough to volunteer to run the 800 meters race. Deepthi told me that I had an impossibly tough race ahead. Suvira Mathur of Blue House has never been beaten in this event, not even at the inter-school events, in fact, she assured me. Suvira holds the Delhi inter-school record for 800 meters. Children, let's read the word meanings that we have come across while reading the first and the second paragraph. I will club the first and the second paragraph together and I'll explain you the word meanings. The first word that we come across here is cope. The meaning of cope is to deal effectively with something difficult. For example, you are in a kind of a difficult situation or a problem, and when you try to come out of that, that is the meaning of, or you bear with the problems that you are facing, that is the meaning of cope, to cope up with that situation or problem. Next word is keep off. The meaning is to avoid. It is to stay away from or to avoid, maybe from a particular person or a situation or a problem. The third word is sting. Sting is basically a very sharp, brief pain. A very sharp pain for a very short moment. To give you an example so that you understand better is, let us take an example of a mosquito. When the mosquito stings you, you have a very, very, very brief and sharp pain. That is the meaning of sting. Let's carry on further.
What happened was, the narrator joined the school the first day. Probably she did not have much of friends, but she became friendly with Deepthi, one of the girls, Deepthi. Now, she was informed that the next day is going to be the selection of the sports event. So basically it was a kind of a sports day that day, the next day. So she was a little excited for that. And somehow she was interested because she had already participated in the sports event in a previous school. So she gave her name for the 800 meter event. Now, when she came the next day, she was a bit excited. She had a feeling of nervousness. Plus the weather also, there was a problem with her. Like, she was staying in Calcutta, where you don't have much of a chilly weather over there. And January, you know, usually it is quite cold here in Delhi, right? So she says that I wasn't ready to adjust myself with the environment, with the weather, because there it was a little warmer weather and here it was quite chilly. Anyhow, she entered the school, she came, she was wearing a red t-shirt and white shorts. Red t-shirt, why? Because she was in the red house. Now you all also, you know, you in your schools also you have different houses and you wear your house t-shirts preferably, particularly during the sports day. So same thing happened with her also. Now when she came, she saw it was the whole ambience and environment over there was so nice. If some people were practicing somewhere, some trials were going on somewhere, some glucose drinks were kept ready for the people who were running in the different events were going on. So she was quite happy and excited seeing that atmosphere. But at the same time, what happened was she was feeling a little lonely because nobody intentionally ignored her. But since she was new, naturally, when there is a new child in the class, everybody is not that familiar to that person. So the same situation was experienced by her. What happened was she saw people busy in their own activities, and some were cheering their own favorites of their own housemates. She was the only one who was a little feeling a little lonely. She said it wasn't done intentionally, but it actually was very, very natural. Now Deepthi told her that you have participated in the 800 event, but it's going to be very tough for her. Why? Because in that event, there was a girl who had participated. Her name was Suvira Mathur. This name has been titled, the chapter title is Suvira, based on that girl, right? So that Suvira Mathur is actually a very good athlete, and she was holding a record of Delhi Inter-School 800 meters race.
Mathur seems to look a winning star. She is wearing new shoes. Everyone knows her. And look at my shoes. They are old and worn. But, no worries. I will give my best. My parents have worked hard to get my admission done here. Now it's my turn. Good luck, Miss Suvira Mathur. And, good luck to me. I too should warm up little and let me test my old spikes on the new unfamiliar track. No one to motivate me, but my positive thinking is with me. Hey, what's that going on? That's a 100 and high jump event going on there. I have never been able to conquer these two events, but today I'll fly.
And then the 800 meters race was announced.
I eyed the said Miss Mathur. She had long, muscular legs and a true runner's easy stride. She had a friendly face which flashed smiles to everyone dressed in a blue t-shirt. But when she moved, she was like well-oiled machinery. I tried to shake off my feeling of certain disaster. I had to make a decent go of this. Now that I'd put myself into this, I may as well give it my best shot. I had won the 800 meters a couple of times in Calcutta. What was the guarantee that Suvira was better and faster than me? Who knows? I could well turn out to be the new heroine of the show. Queen of the fast track or something grand like that. With such wonderful, fanciful thoughts warming the cockles of my heart, I too got up to test my old, slightly battered spikes on the new, unfamiliar track. No one cheered me on as I warmed up, doing springs and stretches to force the winter chill out from my bones and muscles. Only the power of positive thinking and I were out there, hand in hand. I stopped to catch my breath and watch the 110 meters hurdles and the high jump poles. I, somehow, had never been able to conquer these two events. But today, I promised myself I would fly. Okay, children, let's proceed further with the word meanings as we've read the paragraph. The first meaning that we come across, the first word is stride. The meaning is walk. Now, this is just like your walk, the way you walk, but it's a little taking a little longer steps, a little bigger steps than you walk usually. Next word is make a decent go. Now here, referring to make a decent go, this phrase means to be successful or to succeed in something very easily. Now here the narrator is making telling this phrase because she wants to easily and smoothly succeed in the event that she is participating in. Next word is warming the cockles of my heart. Now here, what do you mean by this phrase? It means giving one a comfortable feeling of contentment. Now here, the positive thoughts that she is having, she is having no one to encourage her, right? So she is having such positive thoughts that are encouraging her and that are giving a positive attitude, so that is making her feel a little comfortable, a feeling of contentment. Next word is battered. Battered means damaged by age and repeated use. Now here she is talking about her shoes. The shoes that she is using to participate in the, that she is wearing. Now they are actually used quite for a long time. So she says that they are a little battered, means they are a little damaged. Next word is spikes. Spikes is a pair of running shoes with metal points set into the sole. Now, I think boys, you all must be familiar, because you wear these shoes usually to play football or maybe now. These particular shoes are having metallic pins at the bottom of the sole. Now, these shoes when you wear, usually athletes wear these shoes having spikes. Why? Because it helps the athlete to form a firm grip on the track. Even if the track is wet or it's rough, it is easy for the athlete to have a good grip. It doesn't make him slip while running. Next word is springs. This is a form of exercise in which you move or jump suddenly upwards or forwards. This is a continuous, you know, you keep on doing this exercise continuously. This is just kind of a warm up. Next is stretches. Again, this is also included by Suvira and by the author for the warm up just before participating in the event. This is an exercise where you straighten or extend a part of your body to its full length. You just stretch out that particular, maybe your hands or your body, so that gives you, makes your body a little toned up and keeps you ready for the event you are participating in.
Upon hearing about Suvira Mathur, she got a little eager to see her, who that Suvira Mathur was. So she told Deepthi that I want to see her. And then finally, when she went ahead to see where she was actually wearing a blue t-shirt, because Suvira Mathur was in the blue house and she was doing her warm-up exercises. Now, when she saw her doing the exercise, she felt as if the body, she had a very good toned body. Basically how the perfect athletes have. She had a very flexible body doing the stretches and, you know, all the exercises very flexibly. So looking at her, she felt as if the narrator was losing her confidence. And she also observed one more thing, that she was a very friendly kind of a girl. Why? Because she was smiling at every child who was wearing a blue t-shirt, basically all those who were in the blue house. Then she started losing her confidence. What she did was, she started motivating herself in her mind, you know. These were the thoughts that were coming to her mind. She said, no, I have been participating in Calcutta in the 800 meters event, and I have won couple of times, I have won that event. So maybe who knows that I run better than Suvira. And the other thought that came to her mind was, maybe I can become the queen of the track. So she started motivating herself. She said, now I have entered into this, I have to give my best. All these positive thoughts, they kept on motivating her. And then finally she stood up, and she stood up to check and to inspect her spikes, her shoes, which were a little old, because when she compared her shoes to Suvira, she was wearing new shoes. Now hers were a little worn out, but it was okay. That did not brought her confidence or moral level down. And there was nobody to cheer her up. She was seeing everywhere. There were groups of people who were, you know, cheering, who were calling out names of their friends or their fellow mates who were there in their own houses. So at times her confidence diminished, but then still her own thoughts, she and her positive thoughts, these were two things that were hand in hand, and that kept on motivating her. And then finally she stood up and she just kept an eye, she just looked around what was happening. She just was observing the two events that were taking place, that was 110 meters hurdles and high jump. Now these were the two events, when she saw those two events happening, these were the two events in which she never was able to succeed. She tried to participate, but she says, I never succeeded in those events. But today, with her own, you know, self-motivation, she said, I am going to fly today.
Lots were drawn and I picked up the lot for lane 3. Not a very auspicious start. And guess what? To my next was Suvira Matha taking her position on lane 4. Seeing her definitely I was losing my confidence. And then...
I actually felt as if I was fainting. My heart started sinking. And then, I said, no, come on, I have to prove myself. After all, my family was under a lot of financial pressure as this was an expensive school. I have to live up to by their expectations. And mine as well.
And then I was no more scared. I was confident and fearless to compete Miss Suvira Matha.
And then, the 800 meters race was announced. We drew lots for our lanes and I got lane 3. I had picked the lane right next to Suvira, who was running in lane 4. Not a very auspicious start. A slight tremble shook my dwindling confidence. I admit that for a fleeting moment, I actually considered feigning a faint right there and then. But I couldn't let myself down that badly, could I? No. I may be a lot of things, but I'm not a chicken. Come on. I coaxed my cold limbs as I did another round of quick springs. I had so much to prove and so much to achieve. You see, not only was I new to the school, but also my family and I had come away from Calcutta in what I viewed as unfortunate circumstances. Suddenly, our comfortable lifestyle had vanished. I knew my parents were putting a lot of financial pressure on themselves by admitting me into this good but expensive school. I had to live up to their expectations now, and mine as well.
Let's carry on with the word meanings, children. The first word here is auspicious. Auspicious means favorable. Now here why this word is used, because when the lot for the tracks was done, she got the third track. Now usually you all must have seen on the sports day, you have four different or five or six different positions, right? The innermost is a little easy for the athlete to run. People usually prefer that. Now this narrator, she got the third track. So she says it was not an auspicious beginning for her. That means it was not favorable for her. Next is dwindling. Dwindling means diminishing gradually in size, amount or strength. Now here she refers to the confidence when she just keeps herself ready. She takes the position to start and run for the event. She sees Suvira just beside her. So she feels as if she is losing or her confidence is slowly fainting away. It's deteriorating or going down a little. That is the meaning of dwindling. Feigning means pretending. Just because of these feelings, she felt as if she is going to fall down or as if she is going to faint down. Next is chicken. Now here chicken, please do not misunderstand the word chicken. We are talking about the animal or the creature that we talk about. Now here chicken is referred to cowardly. Cowardly means she tells herself that I am not like chicken. I am not. Whenever you see a chicken and you just try to, you know, catch it, it runs away. So here the narrator tries to say us that I am not like chicken, that I should run away from the situation or I should be scared of the situation. So she says I am not a chicken here. I'm not cowardly. I'm not scared. Next is coaxed. Now coaxed means persuaded someone gradually or gently to do something. To make you understand this word, I'll just give an example. Whenever you as children, you ask your parents or your mother for something which they are not giving, how do you try to persuade them? You try to talk to them sweetly and you keep on always behind them to ask for that particular thing and you're ready to do anything. So when you persuade somebody for something, that is the meaning of coaxed. Let's continue.
And finally, there was a call for the 800 meters race. All the participants were called. So she also went. And that whenever you have to participate in an event, you all must have participated in all the sports, so you must have seen that there is a lot done to give you a selected track. Whichever lot you get, you get that particular track. So now she got the third track. which she felt was not a very, very good beginning for her. Because naturally everybody wants to go for the inner track. But it's okay, somehow she took her place, and then what she observed was just next to her on the fourth lane was Suvira. Now when she saw Suvira, her confidence really lowered down. But then she kept on telling herself, come on, you have to prove yourself, you have to move, you have to fly with the colors today. So with all this courage, she started doing her warm-up exercise. At the same time, she knew that she have to prove herself today. Why? Firstly, because she was new to the school. And I think by achieving something in this event, everybody will be able to know who she was. Secondly, she knew how her family and parents have had hard times to get her admitted to this school. This school was a very, very good school, plus it was very expensive. So it was a big financial burden on her parents. So she knew she had to prove herself, not only for her parents, for herself as well.
Friends, I hope you all are enjoying this video and must have understood the chapter till here. I'm sure you all must be tired reading and understanding the chapter. So, let's wind up today's session. Till then, bye-bye. Thank you. Meet you all in next class.
So children, today we'll be doing the chapter only till here. I hope whatever we read, whatever I explained, you have understood that content very well. Just go through the chapter again. I am going to attach a PDF file which is having a few word meanings. Now there are a few question answers plus a few questions. Now those questions you have to write the answers in your own words. For that I am going to attach the chapter also in your PDF file as well as in the video. So you can go through and you can read the chapter so that you're able to answer those questions. Till we meet again, please read the chapter once more, and if possible, if you feel like, you can read the further part of the chapter so that when I explain that chapter, you'll understand that better. Till then, take care. Goodbye.